How do you do? I'm Dr. John Sace. Welcome to Urban Economics Advanced Topic Number 5. In this video, we will consider the effects that changes in commuting costs and changes in income have upon the demand for real estate in an urban area. Though the bid rent curve can be modeled alternatively with a quadratic function or topological algebra, we will use the standard negative exponential rent density function introduced by Professor Edwin Mills and other pioneers in this field. Let's present our two basic considerations. An increase in household income affects the slope of the residential bid rent function. Generally, the square footage of real estate rented is directly related to income. However, the optimal distance from the central business district, CBD, may vary due to other factors. In addition, commuting costs will impact the bid rent function. A higher elasticity of commuting cost compared to the income elasticity of demand for land leads to a steeper bid rent function as income rises. Commuting costs in themselves are a matter of both time cost and physical cost. The steepening of the bid rent curve suggests that as income increases, residents may prefer to move closer to the CBD due to the relative value of the time cost, or move further out as other amenities take precedence. For example, many high-income individuals prefer to reside in central Manhattan, close to Central Park, or locate further away in the Hamptons on the eastern end of Long Island. Nevertheless, we generally expect bid rent functions to be concave outward, away from the origin. This may explain why the negative exponential function has been agreeable to use by urban economists for decades. With this or similar models, we assume that the horizontal axis represents the distance from point zero at the city center, the CBD, and that the vertical axis represents the rent density as a function of the distance from the CBD. Therefore, we can express our bid rent function as rent equal to large R of mu, a function of the distance mu miles from the city center. We may also consider in this model that rent is a function of radial distance. The curvature of the function is affected by the commuting cost per mile, which in itself is determined by a number of other factors, and the quantity of land demanded by a household, which in turn is determined by various needs and wants. We can express the slope of the bid rent function as the first derivative taken in respect to the distance mu. This derivative can be identified as the inverse ratio of commuting cost to the quantity of land demanded. The slope of the bid rent function is not constant. Rather, it decreases at a decreasing rate. This suggests that the individual values of small t, commuting cost, and or large L, demand for land, as well as the ratio of small t and large L, may vary with distance from the CBD. Generally, we assume that commuting cost, small t, is a positive function of income, such that as income increases, the preference for more comfortable and swifter transport offering greater privacy will be chosen. Likewise, the demand for land, large L, is a positive function of income, such that the greater quantity and quality will be chosen. Therefore, the ratio of these two functions will be negative, with a rate of change that decreases at a decreasing rate as the radial distance from the city center increases. As a result, we can rewrite the first derivative of the bid rent function as the negative of the commuting cost times the land demand function taken to the power of negative 1. Correspondingly, the second derivative of our bid rent function can be expressed as the negative of the first derivative of the commuting cost function in respect to income times the land demand function taken to the power of negative 1, plus the commuting cost function times the land demand function taken to the power of negative 2, times the first derivative of the land demand function in respect to income. For simplification, we may factor out the inverse of the land demand function so that we are left with the second derivative of bid rent being equal to negative 1 over the land demand quantity times the quantity represented by the difference between the first derivative of the commuting cost function and the ratio of the first derivative of land demand times the ratio of the commuting cost to the quantity of land demanded. Next, let's factor out the ratio of commuting cost to income. In turn, this leaves us with a second derivative of the bid rent function being equal to the ratio of commuting cost to the product of income times the quantity of land demanded times the quantity of the difference between the first derivative of the commuting cost function times the ratio of income to commuting cost and the product of the first derivative of the land demand function times the ratio of commuting cost to quantity of land demanded times the ratio of income to the quantity of land demanded. In short, the curvature of the bid rent function changes in respect to individual change in commuting cost and land demand, both in respect to income as well as the proportional relationship of the two costs to one another and to income. Put more simply, the second derivative that expresses the rate of change in respect to radial distance equals the negative of the ratio of the commuting cost to the product of income times the quantity of land demanded times the quantity of the difference between the income elasticities for commuting cost and land demanded. The two terms within the brackets are the elasticities. The first one is the income elasticity of commuting cost, and the second one is the income elasticity of land demanded. I hope that this has helped you to understand this somewhat terse topic. If it has, please like, subscribe, and leave a comment for topics that you would care to view. Thanks, and have a great day.